When I was here 4 years ago, I saw all the pink people running around, and I met a lot of them, and I met Odette, and I met several other people, and just started talking to them about Pink Drive and about what they're swimming for and about the 8 mile. And I just kind of decided then that if I did have the opportunity to get back here for the 8 mile, that it was going to be for Pink Drive, because they're such a great organization. They provide such a crucial service. My message is really essentially just to kind of define your own potential in life, to not allow my challenges to define who I am.
It is an unbelievable honor and privilege to swim with Craig. We met 4 years ago when he came out to swim the 1 mile, and we just instantly clicked. We've both got a passion for life, passion to do anything and everything. And we've been working on this project since 2013 when he came out to swim. And we're absolutely delighted to be in the water together today.
A fish should be in the water, so the fish should be swimming through the water, and it just all makes sense. I'm looking forward to the event. It is my first one, but I'm very excited. What Pink Drive is, you know, for cancer, for women, I think it's very important. You know, it's something that's a big, I can say, issue in this day and age. Then hopefully we can raise as much funds as we can, and awareness, making women and making people understand the problem, and making sure that the ladies can look after themselves when they do have these issues.
This year I said to her, let's do something really special. Apart from raising funds for Pink Drive, which is a charity that we both support, I said to her, just to have someone with me on the boat and to swim all 8 miles and to share the experience in the tent, I thought it would be the most special way to celebrate her coming back into swimming.
It's an amazing charity and an amazing idea to do the Pink Drive for Midmar. I'm really excited.
In the last 4 years, we've been very involved with the Pink Drive, and doing it for a charity, doing it for a cause, and not just to come down and do it with a bunch of friends on the Saturday and then the individual on the Sunday. We've sort of tried to make it a bit more than that. I have no problem with swimming in pink. It's for a good cause. I always joke and say real men wear pink, so it's not a problem at all.
7 years ago, we started training. A friend of mine, whose birthday it is actually today as well, Nikki, we started training for Midmar. It was like November of 2009. Today, 7 years ago, I found the lump, and then 6 years later, I had another lump in the other breast, and then I chose to have the double mastectomy, have treatment, and I'm doing really well, yes.
Now, swimming in pink is no problem at all. As a matter of fact, the guys love it. It's seen as a challenge, because obviously we get a bit of teasing when we're back at the office, but you know, it's all for a good cause, and we realize that. So in the Defence Force, you know, we are here to serve the people, and serving a cause like yours, it's no issue for us as well. The Defence Force members has a natural bond of camaraderie because of our training, because of intensive training, and of course ultimately the love of the sport of swimming that we share amongst ourselves. So, and I can guarantee you, the spirit prevails throughout the year.
We're swimming in pink because it's all about women, and it's all about the ladies, and it's all about the devastation and the very long road that a lot of women have to walk, and the very long road that their families have to walk. So every mile that we do is symbolic for them as well, and the miles that they have to walk.
It's so out there now. It's everywhere. Every step you take, there's someone who's affected by it. So you just can't not come back. You know, it's just one of those things that it keeps pulling you back. It doesn't push you away.
The cancer awareness is so important. So it's the drive to do something good for people who need it that brings us back and makes us want to do it again and pushes us to finish it. And
every year you find out about someone else, and you just got to dedicate a bit to them, you know, just to give them that boost that they need to get through this stage in their life.
Last year I was re-diagnosed with a lump in my chest, so I had very strong chemo and radiation, and now I'm back. But I think the 2 points to take home here is, first of all, one has to go for regular checkups. The second point is, with all my sport, I actually coped quite well with the chemo. I swam through the chemo, not every day, and that kept me going, my mind and my spirits and myself.
Yeah, yesterday was a bit of a challenge on several different fronts, so I was happy to get 3 in yesterday, so if we can get 4 in today, it'll be great.
In the last couple of weeks, the hype and the vibe around the swim and me participating with Craig is just blown out of all proportion. I've to date raised 45,000 rand. It's been amazing.
This time around, it's a little bit more personal for me though. My mom and a friend of mine were diagnosed with breast cancer in August of last year. So they've been undergoing a lot of chemotherapy and that type of thing, and they've still got surgery to undergo. And so I thought, well, it's a fantastic cause. Why not, you know, put the call out there to try and raise some more money? So initially we'd set the target at about 10,000 rand, and today we've officially got 30,000 in. It's surpassed all of our expectations, absolutely blown away by the support.
Last year I came to meet my mom for the first time, fantastic, beautiful event, I won the 50 plus age group last year on my first swim at Mitma. So I'm very proud to be back this year, I'm hopefully going to be as fast as this year, but just being here and swimming is absolutely fantastic. 17 years I've had breast cancer now. I go every 3 months for my checkups, and I'm supported by fantastic family and friends. Get support, get swimming.
It's really so nice to see how these people are well in spirit and want to support Pink Drive and want to support in Pink, because they know that ultimately they are making a difference. On behalf of Pink Drive, I would like to sincerely thank every swimmer who came out, everyone who made a weekend out of it to come and support us. We know it's a difficult swim from time to time, it's not easy to do an 8 mile, but we sincerely appreciate it and we thank you. We thank you to the organisers, everyone involved, for having us, making us part of your event and giving us the platform to raise the awareness and to drive our message that early detection saves lives. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger. Stand a little taller. Doesn't mean I'm lost.